The first challenge is the fast increase of the world population within the context of climate change and also fast decrease of biodiversity. And all of that is happening when the society is putting more and more pressure on farmers not to use chemical inputs. So it's going to be really a challenge to be able to feed 9 billion people with all these constraints and less current technology tools available. We need to really use the potential of nature, which consists of embarking on the agroecology transformation, and this is based on the benefits that the so-called functional biodiversity can bring. It's based on the ecosystem principles, particularly those happening in the soil. And by doing that, you can contain the pest and disease pressure down to a lower level than in conventional agriculture with chemical product, at a point where biocontrol and biostimulants can be valid alternative to the chemical products and provide a satisfactory level of protection to the plants. And with that, you can sustain productivity with much less impact on the environment. This is also making the whole system more resilient, more tolerant to the stress which is brought by the climate change. Smart agriculture can really help in the decrease of the use of chemical pesticide and chemical fertilizer by allowing targeted spraying, by allowing adjustable rates of the application of this pesticide based on the needs of the crop. So that's on the reduction side. On the alternative side, because it can allow to detect pest and disease earlier, to anticipate, it will also put the biocontrol and biostimulant alternative in a better situation to work better. The last thing, it's also help physically to replace chemical herbicides with, for instance, the weeding robots. So I see a lot of possibilities for smart farming to contribute to that. As a matter of fact, we think that it's a key enabler to this agroecological transition. Robots will play undoubtedly a very important part in the future. First, because they will be able to replace mechanical operation and replace labor where needed and when possible, so it will make the whole system more efficient on one end. The second thing is that we can imagine that robots will be equipped with many sensors, and because they will be moving around the field, they will provide more information to the grower and will enable this earlier decision, which will help to make farming more sustainable. So I see clearly these two types of benefits, operational benefits and productivity and efficiency improvement, but also more sustainable farming enabled by the robots, a key element of the ag tech moving into the future. AI is going to be maybe the second or third wave of innovation, which will be probably a game changer. AI will help to understand the performance of the variety, will help to understand how the different environmental factors impact the performance of the varieties. Very importantly, AI will also feed or will use the data collected on this variety and will probably faster the work on the genetics and the genetic innovation and the genetic gain. The challenge with AI is to be able first and foremost to collect the data, and they are quite heterogeneous in agriculture at this stage, but I think it's going to be solved. And what I think also is that AI will not replace farmers. AI will help to really make the most of the empirical knowledge that farmers has. So it will be a tool or it will be a solution to help farmers to make better decisions and to, at the end of the day, be more efficient and be progress faster on the way to sustainable farming.